I asked a question on my Instagram story the other day that was really super simple. Let's say you send a text to someone who usually goes to dinner with you, if you ask, and you ask them to dinner, and they said, I think we'll pass. My question was, if you got this text back, where would your mind go from here? Honestly, where would your first thoughts go? And I got page after page of responses, and I'm actually kind of shocked, but I'm glad that you participated. It really was eye-opening, but not at all surprising, and here's why. Before I started Boundaries, if I got that text back, my mind would go, what did I do? Why aren't they going to dinner with me? Did I do something? Did I do something? Did I do something? What did I do? Did I do something? Are they mad at me? Did I do something? And y'all, I would say 90% of the answers, this is y'all's answer. It was, what did I do? What's going on? You were internalizing it immediately. Your brain was going from this thought to this thought to this thought. You were really honest with me, but that was really the gist. And y'all, the answer is almost always no. It has nothing to do with you or me. Two quotes from the book Boundaries. When we accept others' freedom, we don't get angry, feel guilty, or withdraw our love when they set boundaries with us. Their boundary is not going to dinner because they're doing something else or they just don't want to. And that's their prerogative. Where we have the responsibility in our boundaries is to give them that freedom to say no and not make any deal about it because it has nothing to do with you. It really doesn't. And as I learned about boundaries, I realized that when I hold appropriate, healthy boundaries with me, it gives me the space and the freedom to really actually care deeply about other people. Instead of making this about me, because really, my first thought was, what did I do? Not, I wonder if they're okay or something's happening. So setting boundaries, having my no's and my yeses, they're being accepting of their no's and their yeses helps me be able to love them well and be okay when they say, we're out for dinner. And even in the book Boundaries, it says appropriate boundaries actually increase our ability to care about others. And that is something that I didn't realize I was going to experience in reading this, but something I value so, so much now. And y'all, let's just say on the off chance, it is about you. Maybe you did something that annoyed them. It's still their responsibility to tell you. It's not your responsibility to read their mind. Where the peace comes from is you knowing that your relationships, the relationships that you're keeping in your life, they're going to be able to tell you, to feel strong enough and courageous enough to tell you if it is something that you are doing or have done or whatever. And if you want to ask them, pick another time and ask them, be point blank with them. But then if they say, no, I'm good, then accept that too, because that's what this whole thing is about, really developing healthy, deep, meaningful relationships. And we all want that, right? Boundaries 101.